Everybody on the FPL world, welcome back to GW21 preview. Let's see how we lining up and all the predictions for the game. Don't forget to hashtag FPL Milk on Twitter. And yep, let's do this. As you guys know, it was a terrible week. I got a terrible score. Well, I've always been getting terrible scores, but for some reason, I've been getting green arrows. Finally, this time, I get a terrible score and I get a red arrow. But I think the main reason why is because I made a massive jump in game week 19, and not only that, I do not only just make a massive jump, I also have been getting my captaincy correct, which I think has been the key. You know, captaincy is key, and my initial choice, you guys know, in my game week 9, in my game week 20, game week 19 review, sorry, you guys saw that I captained Mane. In the last minute, had a change of heart, felt like Salah was the man on form, two double digit scores, and you know what, he did what he always does, just like how he did last season when I always used to captain him. He always blanks when I have faith in him. He's like Sterling, you know, it's good to have him, but you just never know when to captain him. But of course, the big, as we've highlighted in the last video, the big scores that helped me to a decent score was Alexander Arnold and Mane. I will take it, and let's hope for better in the coming weeks. These are the fixtures for Gaming 21, the New Year's Day 21. Hopefully everybody will go into the new year nice, and yeah, everybody, I hope you drink one on my behalf. For those of you who drink. And other than that, stay safe, guys, and obviously have a safe and a prosperous new year. We'll see you guys in the new year. I'll still be here. Obviously, the style fixture will be Arsenal and Man United. The late kickoff. It's going to be at night. It's going to be a big game for Arteta. He has to bounce back. I mean, he can't start with two losses. Yes. Enrique. Unai Emery started with two losses against City and Liverpool. But he ended up going on a massive run, which saw us win about 13 or 14 games in a row. So, it can happen, but Man United are not at the level of Man City and Arsenal. I mean, Man City and Liverpool. So, of course, I think we can do one over them. Chelsea, obviously, everyone knows they were lucky. Yes, they did well, and yes, they were dominating in the second half, but they didn't create any chances until we actually gave them a chance later on when Leno made the mistake. But other than that, they didn't do anything in the game. They had possession, but they were not doing anything with the possession. Like why could Arsenal? We scored a lucky goal from a free kick. I'm not saying we were great, but they definitely didn't deserve to be in the lead. Because that's all I keep on hearing. Other than that, obviously another derby, Man City versus Everton. This is how you tied Angelotti back in the big time. Used to have a good record against City when you used to play when you used to manage Chelsea. Maybe you can continue that record. Other than that, yeah, another tight game for Liverpool, but I think Liverpool now, it's done and dusted. It's just a matter of how many and whether can they stay undefeated. These are the predictions. 2-1 to Chelsea. They just got away from home, and I think they'll continue that form. 1-1 to Aston Villa and Burnley. I think Aston Villa will be really wanting to bounce back, and especially against the relegation position. So Burnley are in the mix of relegation. Yes, they started well, but they're in the mix. So of course they want to not lose at least, and I think they'll fight hard to at least get a win or at least a draw. Tottenham, I'm actually not too sure about this, but the only reason why I predicted 2-1 to Tottenham is that Southampton just don't know how to play at home. Yes, they won recently at home, but that was against an easy opponent. What about in future, you know? So let's see how they go about it. Let's see if they can continue this good run they are on. But other than that, they're so good away from home, just like Chelsea. So I expect them to continue their home away form. But also, you know, I think Son will be back, if I'm not mistaken. If he's not, doesn't matter. They'll still have enough to do the job. Eriksen might play for the last time. Who knows? Where will he go? Stay tuned. They'll also be giving you some latest transfer news. And don't mind my dog outside. Leicester, I think they were defeated and deflated after those two horrible results, but against good opponents. But I think they'll be back on their merry way and beat a team that's really can't get going. You know, Newcastle this season haven't been able to string in a constant form like the likes of Wolves and, you know, Norwich at some stage in the beginning of the season. You know, they win one or they draw one, and then just a few losses and so forth and so forth. They're just up and down. So I think Leicester, just like Leicester themselves, they haven't been able to find that consistency. And in this league, you need consistency. I mean, look at Liverpool, look at Wolves, look at, yes, they've lost on games, but the sort of consistency in their game, you know what you're going to expect from them. What for them? Wolves, I think this will be a tight game. I think both teams will go at it. Both teams will want to win it. Who knows what the score is going to be. It's going to be a crazy game, but I think it's going to be 2-2. 2-0 to West Ham. I think West Ham have what it takes to defeat a poor form Bournemouth. Yes, I know Bournemouth have had a big win against Chelsea, but as I said, and I told you this before in the other game, 20 preview, remember that I said that they've been getting lucky goals and they will lose the next game, and guess what, they did. And I think they'll lose this one too. I think Pellegrini will still get fired at some point in the season, but he's definitely not going to lose this game. But you know, I saw great signs, you know, for now. Hence, I'm also picked them in my milk of the match. Stay tuned to find out who I select for the milk of the match. 1-1 at the Derby there at Man City and Everton. I think it will be a tight game. City have still been poor, still without Laporte. Well, I don't know when is Edison gonna come back, but I won't look through that. I have no current stat of that, but he's probably out for a while. And Everton are on form. They've done it against every big team. Everyone thought, it's gonna be hard for them. All the big teams, they're gonna get relegated, gonna stay in the bottom three. Guess what? Change of manager, change of hope, change of atmosphere does it. And let's hope this honeymoon phase doesn't last forever for them, especially for Everton, who are desperate, you know, to become one of the greats again. Norwich, I think, have gone through a period where they've played really well, but haven't been able to get the results. I think this time it will be one of those occasions when they're going to be able to get the results and they're going to be able to get the win, despite Crystal Palace's good form. the big game, Arsenal versus Man United. It's not as big as it was back in the day, but I think Arteta, I saw good defensive display from them. As I said, those two goals by Chelsea were very lucky. If they can play the way they play for majority of the game, about 66, 67 minutes, then they will get that result of 2-0 and can stop the free scoring. Well, they're not free scoring, to be fair. They just playing easy opponents and they doing well against them. Yes, they did well against City, but then they went on to lose all the next couple of games, or draw and lose the next couple of games. So I know what to expect from Man United. They are one of the teams that also like Newcastle, lacking consistency. If they were able to be consistent, they would be in a different place. Liverpool, Sheffield, I think it will be another tight game for Liverpool. I think the players will be a little bit tired, Liverpool, but they're going to get a rest soon. But Sheffield, you know how good defensively they are. They're not going to concede a lot. And even if they do, it could be even a 0-0 game. But even if they do, I think Liverpool will still remain undefeated and Sheffield will keep it tight. I know they conceded 2-1 to Chelsea, but that was just Chelsea being great. But they show what they can do and they can come back from any result. So it'll be a fight. I think it'll be one goal in it, even if it's like 3 for Liverpool, that means it will be 2 for Sheffield. These are the milk of the matches. Mupe, yes, I think Chelsea is going to win, but I think Mupe might be on the score sheet. Greenwich, well, there I had no one to pick from. I don't think there's going to be a clean sheet in that game, so then I had to pick one of the midfielders that are going to do well. I've chosen Westwood, but he hasn't done well, and you know how the strikers have been off form recently, so I chose the one person who's on form and the one person I've been consistent with and who has blanked in a few weeks. Hopefully he can make amends and score again. Ali, he's been out through injury, hopefully he'll be back and back in time to punish. So the Saints, Vardy, another person who's well rested, I like what with him, and hence it's a safer pick. And you know, they get points, they get assists, so for now, picking up form, I probably would have chosen Antonio, but Antonio has been in and out of the treatment table, so you know, we never know with him. Probably Lazzini could have been a good shot too, but looks like there's a fight between him and Lazzini for a spot, but we'll see who gets the slot. For Charleston, he's on form, he will probably do well. Likewise with Pookie. He's not necessarily on form, but I think if no one's going to do anything, Pookie's going to be involved. Like I said, he might not even start this game. You know, 3 games in a row might be too much to ask for him, but he might actually start. And if he does, I think he will be the difference. Robertson, I think since this is going to be a quiet game, he might get the clean sheet and probably the assist. As you know, these are the team that I've chosen on the bench. I start with the bench. But Button, Cantwell, Lundstrom, Henley. I wildcarded, but I didn't change anything in terms of my keepers or anything. I still stuck with the same system. And I've got 0.3 in the bank. And I banked my transfer this week. I've got Cantwell, I've got Lundstrom, I've got Henley. Lundstrom is likely to start. He had a knock. Hopefully he's back in time, but I ain't gonna play him against Liverpool because I have 3 Liverpool players. Grealish, I have faith in him, just like with Charleston, hence I've stuck with him instead of going to players like, you know, De Bruyne. You know, they aren't form, so the rule has always been in FPL, never take out the guy who is on form. Ings is my vice captain. He's been consistent. Likewise with him. Hopefully, all these guys can keep their consistency and outscore anyone who is daring to outscore them. Rico, Paul Dock, Alexandre Arnold. Well, I've already mentioned the triple up. Mane, Salah is included in that. Same with Heat, and majority of them have away games, but hopefully they'll make it big this week. I hope my captaincy this week works out so I can get another green arrow. Anyway, guys, thanks for joining me. This has been the Game Week 21 review. It's been a great half a season, and now a quarter of the season because I only joined midway. But thanks for all the support and all the views, even though it's minor. Thanks for the support, and yeah, it's been an okay year. Hopefully next year can be better. And thanks for joining me. Tell me what you guys think. What do you think of all the differentials I have in the team? And yeah, who do you guys have? Comment your team below. And yeah, what do you suggest with my team? Who are you guys captaining? Thank you guys. Happy New Year.